Welcome to the Scottish Borders. Today, I found myself another beautiful coastline town with an exquisite harbour to explore. Welcome to Eyemouth. Almost unknowingly, I've been gradually doing all the major harbours from Edinburgh down the east coast towards Newcastle. So I've done Fisherrow, of course, and I've done Dunbar, and we've been to Cove Harbour, beautiful Cove Harbour, St Abbs, and today, Eyemouth. So I definitely want to check out the harbour. There's a final destination I have in mind here in Eyemouth, which I've been really looking forward to seeing. Now, Eyemouth Harbour is long and thin, and there's some really interesting stuff over there, including a turret, which I believe is a B&B. So I want to go over that side first, and then I'm going to have to retrace my steps because there's only one crossing point, obviously, and then we'll head up the other side of the harbour, and that's where the town is. This is much more of a working harbour than some of the harbours I've visited down the east coast. Look at the size of some of these boats. RNLI. Those are really steep sides to the harbour, aren't they? Definitely need to be really careful on the edge here. Now, if we go across this bridge, I think we've got something up there that's called Gunsgreen House. And up there on the clifftop, that little turret, I think, is actually a bed and breakfast. Well, let's check out Gunsgreen House first. And I love that castle wall there. Gunsgreen House certainly has prominent position overlooking Eyemouth from here on the top of the turret walls. Well, it is a museum, but unfortunately it's not open today, which is a real shame because it's subtitled The House of Secrets. I guess I'm not going to find out what those secrets are today. Let's head up to that turret that masquerades as a B&B, shall we? Do you know, I just love exploring little towns like this, just following my feet and seeing what I can find. It's called Nisbet's Tower, and of course it's higher up on the cliff, and there are some fabulous views of the rest of Eyemouth and the cliffs and the coastline beyond. Actually, I was wrong about Nisbet's Tower. It's not a B&B, it's an AirBnB. You can actually rent it from £121 a night. I reckon it must be a pretty cool place to stay. Right, so I want to head into the town itself. So what we're going to have to do is go back down over the Red Bridge and then retrace my steps all the way along the harbour, over the other bridge, and then across the other side. Look at Ellen Mack over there, LH272. That's a bit of a chunky boat, isn't it? Well, I've crossed back over now, so we're on the town side of the harbour. Some great views of that RNLI boat. Looks like we've got an Oblo bar and bistro. What a cool name. And I think round this corner there might be a fish and chip shop. The facade of this building is covered in shells. Look at that. Yes, there is. It's a fish and chip shop. Do you know what? I fancy a tray of chips. And after everything I said in my last video down in Penrith in the Lake District about not being able to get chips and gravy here in Scotland, look what I've got. Yay, chips and gravy. In Eyemouth, in Scotland. Well, here we go again. Mmm, those are great chips. I'm going to start looking like a chip if I'm not careful. Those chips were absolutely sensational. If truth be told, they were better than the chips I got in Penrith last week. Another little bar, pub, restaurant here. I love that, though. The contented soul. Love the play on words. Let's go and take a closer look at the harbour mouth. Yeah, there are some quite rugged cliffs over there on the other side. And quite a bit of a swell on the sea today. It's not that windy, though. And there we have the harbour mouth. Oh, it's quite high up here, and no railings. Have to be very careful. Down onto the beach. Oh, it's very, very bracing today. Actually, right down here on the beach, it's bloody freezing cold. But it certainly blows the cobwebs away. Just up from the beach, and let's have a quick wander around the town and some of its fabulous old buildings. Look at this one. This pub is the Fleet, Eyemouth's hidden gem. Just off the harbour are some of these pretty little streets with some fabulous old buildings. Love the colours. Wind and wave. And up on the promenade, this monument is what I came to Eyemouth today to see. The memorial for the Eyemouth disaster of 1881. When I visited Cove Harbour and St. Abbs Harbour in earlier vlogs in this series of harbour visits down the East Coast, I saw smaller versions of this memorial in those locations. But here in Eyemouth, the death toll in that disaster was the highest. Hence, this is the biggest version of the memorial. And it features the 78 wives and the 182 children who were left behind when the fathers died in that disaster. This is really sobering. Forever looking out onto the sea. This plaque tells the whole story, widows and bairns. Now, I've seen the statues in St. Abbs, I've seen the statues in Cove. I've yet to see the statues in Bournemouth, but that's for another day and another vlog. Well, do you know, one of the things I love about doing vlogs like this is going places where I can really feel the power of history. And do you know what? Nowhere have I been recently where I've truly felt the sad power of history. This memorial is truly, truly powerful. And I think that is where I'm going to end the vlog today. Thank you so much for watching this episode of Rog Vlog. Until the next video, remember, there's always something to see. So get out there and find it.